So the hush money trial in Manhattan is not the only hearing that Donald Trump has had this week. Obviously, on Thursday, he's got the big one in front of the Supreme Court that he's not allowed to attend. But also on Monday was the hearing with Judge Arthur Eron about the bond payment that he made through Knight Specialty Insurance Company, which, of course, is owned by a good buddy of his. They put up the $175 million bond. And then, of course, New York Attorney General Letitia James had raised a bunch of questions about some of the problems the company had with the judge, to the point where the judge had said a couple weeks ago, we've got to do a hearing on this. And as I said, they did the hearing on Monday, where the judge eventually, after many, many concessions from Trump's people, said, okay, I accept the bond. So a couple of the concessions that Donald Trump's lawyers made, and this was actually one of the big issues brought up by Letitia James, was that originally the bond was put forward and Trump backed it up with an account with the money in it, but he still had access to the cash. So even though that cash was backing the bond, Donald Trump could have still, in theory, withdrawn the cash. He could have moved it. He could have made massive purchases. And that, under New York law, totally not allowed. So one of the concessions they made is, okay, we will not touch the money. Trump will not touch the money. Nobody can have access to it at all. So they made that concession. The second concession they made is that, okay, also, you know what? We will, at your request, give you monthly updates on the financial status. We'll tell you how everything is. We'll show you what everything is. We're not going to touch it, and we'll give you proof every month that we didn't touch it. Judge said, okay. But what really sealed the deal was that Donald Trump's lawyer, Christopher Keese, decided to just give up the farm. Because at one point during a back and forth where, you know, the prosecutor's office was like, hey, this bond is not acceptable. We don't know if he's actually got the money. Trump's lawyer Keese jumped in and said this. There's hundreds of millions of dollars worth of real estate that the defendants own right here in the city that could be seized with the stroke of your pen. Oops. Because it was shortly after that that the judge says, judge accepts it and court is adjourned. So here's what happened. Let me explain that to you so that you understand the significance of what Trump's idiot lawyer said. He said, listen, even if the guy touches the money that's backing the bond, right? Even if they can't pay it, don't forget, he has so much property around here that you could just, you know, sign off on it and you could just start taking it from him right now if you wanted. So what's the big deal? And at that point, the prosecution agreed. They were like, you know what? Yep, we're good. And the judge was like, fantastic. We'll do it. I'll hold you to your word. Gavels it out. Done. So Trump's lawyer has now given the court the green light to, if Trump doesn't pay, you guys can immediately start seizing his assets. The judge accepted that. Like, that was an argument from Trump's lawyer. It was essentially an offer made to the court. And the judge said, deal. So, oopsie daisies, you probably shouldn't have said that because you were already, like, good to go. But you added that. That is now official. It is now a part of the ruling. And if Trump misses a single dollar, his assets can now be seized, thanks to his idiot lawyer. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.